all you need to know about contemporary treatment mechanics in one single book. Hi, my name is Alex, and today I'll be looking at the book Fundamentals of Orthodontic Treatment Mechanics. It's been written by John Bennett and Richard McLaughlin. Yes, if you are using MBT prescription, the letters M and B stand for their names. The book was published by Legrande Publishing in 2014 and is the last book in a popular trilogy by the authors. First of all, I want to say that I genuinely like this book. It's very practical and contains plenty of useful advice, structured neatly in 14 chapters. Frankly, I think if I had a chance to read it during my residency, I would have done less mistakes during my first years in clinical practice. This is a nitty-gritty of clinical orthodontics. No beating around the bush, just clear and precise guidance accompanied with dozens of schemes and a good number of well-documented cases. The book starts with a chapter on diagnostics where you will learn about the concept of true vertical line. Long story short, this parameter will help you to consider soft tissues while planning a case. Next, we have several chapters on bracket design, their positioning, special enamel etching method that, according to the author's experience, might be helpful in preventing white spot lesions. Special attention is paid to bracket inversion, for example for class 3 compensation, better torque control of palatally displaced canines, and for some other tricky situations. There are individual chapters on interproximal enamel reduction, premolar extractions, and one of my favorite on finishing, titled Settling the Case. The book ends with chapters on appliance removal, the placing of retainers, and post-treatment period. And here is my most loved line from this book. Unfortunately, insistence from patients that they don't want premolars extracted does not change an extraction case into a non-extraction case. In conclusion, this book is an invaluable source of advice and clinical tips. I highly recommend it to all last year residents and young orthodontists. I think if you will stick to the principles described in this book for the first several years in practice, you will avoid many mistakes along the way. A lot of what I do now is correlated to these principles, apart probably from indirect bonding. I really like direct bonding since in my hands it turned to be much cleaner and more precise procedure. And in the end, I want to say that reading all these orthodontic textbooks on different philosophies, I can't stop feeling that each of them is based on good old principles that originated back in 1940s in the United States of America. I'm talking about such fundamental orthodontic rules as keep initial arch form, do not expand intercanine width, pay attention to anchorage control, and so on. To conclude, I think that this is another great book on common sense orthodontic principles, which in this case are known as McLaughlin-Bennett system. You can buy this book by clicking the link in the description below. Please subscribe to my channel, and I wish you good reads and stable results.